Sometimes I lay under the moon. I thank God I'm breathing. And I pray, don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason.
Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around. Because all my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for, people to say that we don't wanna fight no more. There'll be no more war, and our children will pay.
People,
yeah, thank you. I know I look so good in these glasses. I'm so happy.
Your name and one word for today. Ready? Go.
Whoa, Gus. I have no idea. I'm too slow for this.
Finn, you're.
Mia, affinity. Harper, boombox.
Name and the word of the day.
Julia. Wagon wheel.
Round. Ramen.
Round.
You gotta get the good angle.
Ramen.
You gotta get the good angle.
Obi has stomach diarrhea. Pepto-Bismol is the cure.
Sometimes in my tears I drown. I drown. But I never let it get me down.
Get me down.
So when negativity surrounds.
Surround.
I know someday it'll all turn around. Because all my life I've been waiting for.
Waiting for.
I've been praying for.
Praying for.
For the people to say that we don't wanna fight no more.
Sprite with my butt ski.
All right, here we are with three incredibly powerful women from Animas High School.
Yes.
And I just wanted to ask a quick question.
Okay.
What does, when you hear culture of excellence, what does that even mean to you?
I think it means striving to be your best intellectual and personal self. And advocating for your needs.
To me, it means holding yourself accountable and pushing yourself and setting standards high for yourself. Not high that they're unattainable,
yes.
But, you know, pushing yourself.
Balance is important.
Balance is important.
In the culture of excellence.
It's true.
And being kind.
Christina Bo-Davis, what about
yes.
you?
Yes. Being kind. I think
Preach.
That's a really, really important thing that everyone can always work on.
Yes,
true.
Thank you. Here we have a couple of grade niners at Animas High School, new to this year, Emma and Ayla. When you hear the word culture of excellence, what does it make you think of?
A big, happy community that supports each other.
Yeah, being your best self and supporting everyone around you no matter what.
Are you seeing this happen in our school on a day-to-day business?
Yeah.
Do you see days when it's not happening?
Yeah, for sure. But there's more days that it happens than there is that it doesn't.
Awesome. If you could change one thing about the culture of our school in a direction that you'd want, what would that look like?
Probably the respect for the school, like, property.
Yeah.
Like the bathrooms and stuff. That's one thing I would change.
And as we move into a new building, what hopes do you have?
That the respect is way better than it is here.
Just because we're leaving this place doesn't mean that we have to trash it.
Yeah. And I hope it's different at the new building.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hi. I am Lori Fisher. I teach 10th grade humanities.
When I hear culture of excellence, what it really makes me think of is that we are all working together as a team to accomplish really cool stuff. And we're all contributing like as best as we can to that effort. I hope that we can grow into the animus that we've been trying to be for 13 years. Now that we have a space, it's like moving a flower into a bigger pot. I want us to become big and beautiful, even more so than we already are.
I like animus. I don't know. I feel like it's a lot smaller, so I know a lot of people, and then like I can mingle with different kids in different grades, which is not it's a good thing. Well, it's not like DHS where you like just have a teacher. It's like a mentor kind of thing, or like a friend, because they can like be more your friend, because it's not like in the general like school idea where it's like they're higher, you're lower, they have the power. I like that.
Culture of excellence, it's kind of like, when I think about it, I think about people being respectful of each other's beliefs, opinions, whatever, sexuality, gender identification, and also like respecting teachers and making sure that you keep a mutual respect, because that's what animus is about a lot of the time, is just mutual respect and helping each other.
Okay.
I mean, doing your work on time and trying to do the best work you can do always. And as long as you do your best work and always put in 100% effort, you'll do well, because that's what teachers want to see, is growth and development.
Oh, it's an actual camera in my face.
Okay.
My hopes and dreams for animus? I mean, I just want this school to be a place where our community is so strong and so supportive of one another that we are all trying to help each other be the best versions of ourselves. And that involves the academic work that we do, the way that we show up every day for each other as humans, being present with each other. It involves creating an inclusive culture where everyone can feel a sense of belonging, where there's no us versus them dynamic between students and staff at the school. Where that, from that foundation of just a really strong community, then we can do next level projects in the world and make waves in our community beyond the four walls here, and be of service to other people in this community, be able to go on amazing trips together that involve the academic work that we're doing. That's kind of one of my visions. But I don't think we're there. I think there's a lot of barriers right now that are preventing us from doing excellent work. I think technology is a barrier sometimes. I think there's a lot of distractions that we're all experiencing. I think we're all struggling with coming back from a pandemic for 2 years and trying to figure out what it means to do this thing called school again. And so I think we have some work to do.
I'm gonna get to class.